Did you know that the first soap was made around 2800 BC in ancient Babylon? Yes, you heard it right. The concept of cleanliness has been ingrained in human civilization for nearly 5,000 years. The Babylonians were the trailblazers in soap making, a venture that began not with fancy fragrances or skin conditioners, but with simple ingredients, fats and ashes. Imagine the scene. The Babylonians in their ingenuity boiled fats, probably from their livestock, with ashes. This was no random experiment, but a calculated process. The fats contained fatty acids, which when boiled with ashes, a form of alkali, underwent a chemical reaction. The result? A rudimentary form of soap, a product that could clean. It was a discovery that would echo through the ages, forever changing our approach to personal hygiene and cleanliness. This is the birth of soap, an invention as old as civilization itself. Now, isn't that a cleaning revelation for the ages? Modern soap production has come a long way from its Babylonian origins. Originally, soap making was a crude affair with fats and ashes playing the starring roles. But as we stepped into the modern era, the process underwent a dramatic transformation. It became more refined, more sophisticated, and more focused on specific needs. The evolution of soap production is a tale of innovation. It's a story of how we move beyond the simple goal of cleanliness to create products that cater to a diverse range of skin types and preferences. Today's soaps are not just about hygiene, they are about fragrance, about skin friendliness, about luxury. They are crafted from carefully chosen ingredients designed to delight the senses while keeping the skin healthy and glowing. Soap production today is a blend of art and science where ancient wisdom meets cutting-edge technology. So, we've come a long way from fats and ashes, haven't we? The heart of modern soap is often plant-based oils, with olive oil being a popular choice. Yes, you heard it right. Olive oil, a staple in your kitchen, plays a starring role in soap production. But why, you may wonder? Well, let's delve into this liquid gold. Olive oil brings quality and mildness to the soap-making table. Its gentle nature makes it a perfect choice for sensitive skin, and its rich, nourishing properties leave skin feeling soft and moisturized. Not to mention it contributes to a soap's longevity, meaning your bar will last longer. But how is olive oil processed for soap making? It begins with either hand harvesting or mechanical means to gather the olives. Then follows cleaning, crushing, and malaxation to extract the oil. This oil is then ready to enter the magical world of saponification, where it transforms into soap. So the next time you see olive oil, remember it's not just for salads. Ever heard of saponification? It's the key chemical reaction that makes soap. Now let's put on our chemistry hats for a moment. Saponification is the process that transforms oils into soap. It's the alchemical dance that occurs when fatty acids and oils meet an alkali, in this case, sodium hydroxide. Imagine, if you will, a grand ballroom. On one side, you have the fatty acids found in our star ingredient, olive oil. They're the belles of the ball, twirling in their elegant gowns. On the other side, you have the alkali, sodium hydroxide, strutting in with a confident swagger. The music strikes up, the two meet, and voila, a reaction occurs. They whirl and twirl, forming a new compound. This is saponification, the magical moment when soap is born. But there's more to this dance than meets the eye. In the midst of this waltz, a valuable byproduct is also formed, glycerin. This humble compound may not be as glamorous as soap, but it's a star in its own right. Glycerin is an excellent moisturizer, and it's highly sought after in industries like cosmetics and pharmaceuticals. Now, you might be wondering why we're talking about all this chemistry. Well, understanding the science behind soap helps us appreciate the process and the product even more. It's not just about cleanliness. It's about the art and science of transforming simple ingredients into something that can keep us clean and healthy. Saponification is a process that's been honed and perfected over centuries. It's a testament to human ingenuity and our never-ending quest for better ways to live our lives. So the next time you lather up with your favorite soap, take a moment to appreciate the science that went into creating it. So, a bit of chemistry can indeed keep us clean. Now that we know the chemistry, let's dive into how soap is actually made. The creation of soap is a fascinating blend of chemistry and artistry, starting with the heating of our star ingredient, olive oil. This process is carried out in large stainless steel vessels designed to withstand the high temperatures necessary for the transformation of oil to soap. The goal here is to create the perfect environment for the saponification reaction to take place. Once our olive oil has reached the optimal temperature, the next step in our soap symphony is to introduce our alkali, typically sodium hydroxide. This is added gradually, ensuring a controlled reaction. The mixture then begins a dance of transformation as the oil and sodium hydroxide react to form soap and glycerin. But this isn't just a matter of adding ingredients and hoping for the best. Oh no, this is a carefully choreographed process that requires constant monitoring. The temperature must be maintained within a specific range to ensure the reaction continues at the right pace, while the pH levels are carefully tracked to confirm that saponification is indeed happening. This is where the magic happens, folks. The fatty acids in the olive oil are reacting with the alkali, breaking down and reforming as soap molecules. It's a complex ballet of elements, all under the watchful eye of the soap maker. But it's not just about the soap. Remember the glycerin we mentioned? This valuable byproduct is separated from the soap mixture. Glycerin is a fantastic moisturizer and can be used in a plethora of other applications, from cosmetics to pharmaceuticals. Nothing goes to waste in this process. So there you have it, the transformation of simple olive oil into a bar of soap through the power of chemistry. From heating the oil and adding the alkali to monitoring the temperature and pH levels, each step is crucial in the journey from humble ingredient to the soap that keeps us clean and fresh. And that, folks, is how a bar of soap is born. But what makes one soap different from another? It's all in the finishing touches. As we delve into the world of soap production, the secret recipe lies not just in the basic ingredients, but also in the subtle nuances that each soap maker brings to the table. Let's talk about some of these finishing touches that make each bar of soap a unique piece of art. Fragrances, for instance, add a sensory dimension to the soap. Imagine stepping into a shower and being greeted by the invigorating scent of peppermint or the soothing aroma of lavender. These scents are achieved by the careful addition of essential oils, each with its own therapeutic properties. Some oils, like tea tree or eucalyptus, have antibacterial properties, while others, such as chamomile or sandalwood, offer a calming effect. Then we have colorants. These are used to give the soap its visual appeal. From the rustic browns of cinnamon soap to the vibrant greens of aloe vera, colorants bring the soap to life. And it's not just about aesthetics. Some colorants, like turmeric or beetroot powder, come with their own skin benefits. Moisturizers are another key player in the soap formulation. Ingredients like shea butter, coconut oil, or even honey are added to ensure the soap doesn't dry out your skin. These natural emollients help keep your skin hydrated, soft, and supple. Now let's talk about the physical form of the soap. Once the soap mixture is ready, it's extruded and cut into the desired shapes. This could be the traditional rectangular bar or something more creative like a shell, a flower, or even a tiny teddy bear. After shaping, the soap is left to dry. This drying process helps to remove any excess moisture, making the soap harder and longer lasting. In essence, it's these final steps that truly define the soap. The fragrance that lingers on your skin, the color that catches your eye, the shape that fits perfectly in your hand, and the softness that it leaves on your skin. It's these final steps that give each soap its unique character. Quality control and waste management are critical parts of soap production. This isn't just about creating a bar of soap, oh no. It's about crafting a product that's safe, effective, and environmentally responsible too. Quality control measures are implemented throughout the process. Think pH testing to ensure the soap is skin-friendly, safety checks to verify the absence of harmful substances, and sensory evaluations to confirm the soap feels and smells just right. But it doesn't stop there. After the soap is made, we still have byproducts to deal with. That's where responsible waste management comes in. Byproducts aren't simply dumped. Instead, they are recycled, treated, or disposed of safely. This helps minimize the environmental impact of the soap production process. So, you see, soap making is not just a craft, it's a responsibility. It's about maintaining the promise of quality and showing respect to our environment. So the soap production process is not just about making soap, but also about maintaining quality and being responsible to the environment.